All right, YouTube, I don't know where it cut off, but the December 2019 Premier Firearms Auction, so many items that have never been seen before by the collecting public, never been photographed before, never been offered, never been out of the families that they've come from. Rare, historic, and incredible items. And as you can see, some heavy firepower as well. So like I said, I've been up since 3. I can't sleep. This is gonna be a crazy auction, and I wanna show you some of it as we walk through our preview haul. Let me flip the camera around, and we can start taking a look at some of the goodies. First things first, a Powell indicating device, AKA the cartridge counter Luger. Only 50 made within a very specific serial number set, made for American trials. It is a 9mm. Perhaps only second in rarity slash desirability to the mythical unicorn-like status of the 45 caliber Luger. To my wall, it might not be terribly exciting. There's a big blank wall. I'm here before anybody else. This is actually where we will have all the machine guns. We are offering machine guns on day one. This is everything from a 1919, where there's a couple potato diggers, some Mod Deuce. It's gonna be good. And even a case of smaller ones. You can need a MAC-10, M11, MP5s, a well rod, actually. If you saw our Instagram account yesterday, it got quite a bit of attention. This is where the well rod will be. Come in and see it. As we do like to mention, preview day, everything in this hall, about 2,800 items. We're gonna sell in 3 days. Today, from 10 a.m. till 6 p.m., it is open to the public. Come in, touch it, look at it, inspect it. Get an education, even if you've never seen some of these items, or there's items you just wanna know more about. These auctions in the preview day is just an incredible opportunity to learn about, you know, some of the different trims, some of the different things that were available in various makes and models. Here's a beautiful Conrad Ulrich. I'm gonna get right in on this Peabody Martini, because the work on that is incredible. If that wasn't enough, right around the corner is another beautiful Remington rolling block, silver and gold plated. We got a little two-tone action. Got a little shooter right there, actually. That could be you. Look at that, that could be you with this Remington. Looks like he's knocking down a game bird over there on the left. Maybe a woodcock. More Remingtons. We have to, if you haven't seen some of the other videos on our YouTube channel, these two Remingtons are both in their own video of Remington. Find Remingtons that are offered in the sale. Oh, what's behind me? Oh, no. Just a gorgeous Volcanic with a 25-inch barrel. Good grief. Look at the finish on that thing. Not bad for over 150 years old. And a Hogson engraved Henry. And this is one of those fresh pieces, boys and girls, where it has not before been offered, but you can see the very traditional Hogson pattern with the flower up front and leaping stag. You can kind of see that. And we're gonna go quick. Obviously, there's no way we can avoid giving short shrift to all the guns that we have on display. This beautiful Colt Patterson 1839 revolving carbine from the Robert M. Lee collection. If you're not familiar with Robert M. Lee, yes, he does have a wing. He does have a section in the Metropolitan Museum Arms and Armor section. As you can see, we have a pretty incredible selection of cannons and field guns and howitzers, well, you name it. But before we get to those big guns, let's get to one of the big dogs of the auction. As you can see on its pedestal all by itself, this is a panel scene engraved Colt. This has its own video. I mean, there's the panel scene. This has its own video on our YouTube channel where our president, Kevin Hogan, really gets in detail about why this is significant, why this is so significant, why it's important to Colt collectors, how rare they are, their place in the expositions of the late 19th century. So just a absolute monster of a Colt. Again, this is not only a monster, not only a rare one, another like newly discovered Colt. This one has not been offered before. Although there are other panel scene Colts, of course, but not that one. So that's gonna be a first time for a very advanced collection. Here is a, pardon me, it's that time of year, everybody. You get a little frog in your throat. A beautiful 1842 dated Ames 1841 6-pounder smoothbore cannon. And I know about this one because we just wrote an article a 16-page article and featured it in Artilleryman magazine. Really cool cannon as far as the history of American artillery. This one, with its 1842 date, of course, has could have seen action in the Mexican-American War, or in the Texas Republic and down there, as well as early Civil War, when basically any available gun was pressed into service. So a lot of history here, a lot of importance and significant as a design, as the United States started to really standardize its artillery and cannon post-Revolutionary War and War of 1812, when, like I said, they basically just took whatever they can get. And here's one that's also been getting quite a bit of attention because it's absolutely gorgeous. This is a M1911, serial number 81. It's just that simple. We have a great video on this on YouTube, and I don't just say that because I'm in it, but it is beautiful. Look at the blue popping off that trigger. Wish you could show the other side too, because the slide release, but you can see it on the hammer spur there. Just that beautiful, beautiful Colt early finish blue. Belonged to General Lutz Vall. His four medals are there. He was stationed in the Spanish-American War, which then turned into the Philippine Insurrection. He was a border guard on the border of Mexico when Pancho Villa was making incursions in the United States, so border protection was really, really important at that point. And also served in the Great War. If you watch the video on YouTube of this weapon, you will see footage of Lutz Vall reading the telegram of the armistice on November 11th, 1918. Like, this thing is just, it's just dripping with history. Sporting arms. More sporting arms. One of the significant ones of the sale here. Always desirable. Colt Walker, well, 1847. One of the big guys. This is D Company. I don't remember the number off the top of my head. I think it's 134. 124? 124? It wouldn't be 134. But always a pleasure to have Walker. Rock Island Auction Company would often go many years in the past without offering a Walker. Now we've been able to see them quite regularly, including last September. They did offer the one, or sell the one for over $1 million. So always a treat, always a privilege to have a Colt Walker in a sale. Oh, what's this? Oh, just a Gullwing, just Mercedes Gullwing. Sorry about the lights, everybody. They are motion censored. So as I'm making my way back across the auction hall, these should be turning on again. Here is, one of my favorites of the sale. Little 1902 military, got that waffle checker pattern on the front, got that blue trigger. Just see if I can catch that in the light here, find that nighter blue showing off. Okay, maybe I can't, but it's still beautiful, and it's right next to a 1900 sight safety. that is an attractive case, if I do say so myself. It's a beautiful Colt single actions. Well, it's 10 shot. Yes. Yes, you're seeing that correctly. It does have two triggers. We have a blog on one of those somewhere. Kind of like the Lindsay, the more perhaps more well-known Lindsay two shots with also two triggers. And I'm going through and showing the guns, and I apologize in advance. I'm not explaining much about the auction or preview day in and of itself. As we mentioned before, we are open to the public. And we have the preview hall divided into each day of the auction, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. So everything from this wall back to the very beginning, we will sell on Friday. We will sell on day one. And that includes not only all the sporting gun racks, all the cannons, all the special pieces, everything in those cases back there. Those are our handgun cases. We will sell everything in there as well as the machine guns, which will be lining that far wall over here. That will all be sold on day one. Everything from this case back, again with the handgun cases, this special display, and this special display, which we will get to in a moment, that will be sold on Saturday. So that'll be another, 1,100 or so guns, or 1,100 lots. And everything from this wall over, that will be sold on Sunday. So we kind of have things divvied up in the preview hall to make it easy to find, so you can find what you're looking for, so you can inspect it, so you can feel confident in bidding on it. We found that helps quite a bit. So Saturday, let's cut right to brass tacks here. More artillery or siege cannons. More class 3 will be over there. Like I said, once people start getting in, we do lock those up securely every night. We do have a little Gatling out. That's always fun. Look at some of these. Here's a rare bird. This is a Type 2 Hamada. Very, very rare Japanese semi-automatic pistol. This one's, as you can see there, serial number 28. Quite a prize, a rare prize. I think we've sold 3 of them in my time being here. And as long as we're talking about guns I like, why not this? Another 1902 military, and that is cherry, my friends. That is quite a cherry piece. And if that wasn't enough, let's get to what I think is probably the star of the show. At least the one with the most provenance that people have heard of. This is Marlin 1897 Deluxe, clearly deluxe, gold wash, factory engraved, carved stock, belonged to none other than Miss Annie Oakley. You can see perhaps on the other side of the stock, that zoomed in real fast, a presentation plaque. This is actually presented to Annie Oakley from the Marlin factory. And this would have been about 1903. Now, she was presented another one by Marlin in about 1906, but this is definitely the first of the two. Give him a little sure shot. Letters that document it. It's incredible to hold this rifle, to place your hands where her hands were, to put your cheek on the stock where her cheek laid. I mean, she's an American icon. She's an American icon. She's a legend. She borders on myth. But her exploits are certainly not her, nor is her shooting. We have a video on this too, on the YouTube channel. If you haven't seen it yet, please go do so. I say it's really good again and again, not just because I'm in it. What a beautiful LeMat on day 2. Beautiful route. It's another one. It's a video on the YouTube channel. Go check it out. Ooh, but there's one that's not, and I want to whip around and go show it to you. First of all, some of the Smith & Wessons in this auction are absolutely out of this world. That's Corf Patterson. But some of the Smith & Wessons in this auction are out of this world, and that is courtesy of the Dr. Gerald Klatz collection. You can see right there we have some highlighted over here because we are going to walk around, yes, past beautiful Winchester 95s to look at that beauty. Tiffany & Company embellished Smith & Wesson 38DA. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. You will see pictures of this. You will see other similarly embellished Tiffany Smith & Wessons in the Metropolitan Museum of Art. They are instantly recognizable. They are supremely collectible. This is the real deal. With a $60,000 to $90,000 estimate, it should go to a very good home. Here we have another. We have a Tiffany grip on a Colt, but it's been embellished by New York retailer. Probably where our description says likely Hartley Graham, Hartley and Graham in New York. And then this gorgeous, gorgeous silver leaf cast holster to match. Beautiful work. If you've seen our blog, you recognize this Tiffany & Company officer's sword. Some fantastic Civil War era history behind it. It's beautiful. It has this cruciform cross guard, the straight cross guard, very, very rare. The chain hand guard, also very, very rare pattern of sword to be offered from Tiffany & Company. And as you can see, it is absolutely gorgeous. I know it's kind of hard to see with all those lights that we're using to show it off, which make it really easy to see in person and really hard to film. And then a gorgeous Tiffany & Company designed huge Bowie knife. This is actually engraved by master engraver Alvin White, who has some of his personal collection, not just items he's engraved, his personal collection is in this auction. Again, we have a YouTube video on it. If you want to find out more about it, you should definitely check it out. Some Civil War history, real Civil War history, like identified Confederate swords, period carbines. Beautiful, beautiful things. We may not have the class 3 on the table yet, all the machine guns, like a Winchester bar, but we do have a lot of the trainers. Now, I've seen a lot of trainers, and I have never seen some of these all-metal classroom cutaways before. They are they make an impression. Like the regular cutaways are great, and this one has the even the color-coded interior, which makes it distinct from some other ones. But these all-metal ones with the polish, those those make their presence felt. Oh, why don't we walk around and find out on Sunday? I don't know. Okay, maybe not. But we'll look at the Saturday. Some of these old advertisements, I really appreciate. They're bright, they're colorful, they're things you would have seen as a kid. For me, probably would have been Red Ryder ads, but I can still appreciate an ad for Model 90 and its subsequent iterations. We have beautiful, one last thing on Saturday, this beautiful Winchester 66. I wouldn't be doing my job if I didn't show you the engraving on this. This is by Thomas O'Connell. Just beautiful. You look at the detail on that. Gold gilt. Beautiful, beautiful deluxe Winchester 66. So everything else on this side will be Saturday, or on Sunday, the final day of auction. Look, you just walk right up, and you never know what you're going to see. This is an early, early, early Winchester 66, and you can tell because it has that flat gate, the flat loading gate. There's no scallop in it to being pushed in. It also has a flat portion right here. There's no slight scallop kind of out of the wood where the frame comes up to meet it. It's out all the way and flat, flush from wood to metal right there. So very, very early Winchester 18-6, and so many gorgeous Winchesters on this table. You see some Ulrich engraving? We can get in on that for you. Hunting dog chasing hare. Look at the engraving, even on the hammer, the case hardened hammer, no less. And on the lever. Beautiful stuff. Your Colt, oh, it was an 1874, is a Camel Gatling gun. They are something. That's a lot of firepower in a small package. Winchesters, U.S. military. We take a quick walk around. You can get, or even a mule. You can get a USMC mule. Or Winchesters. But this is what you get when you walk around the racks in the preview hall. You know what you're going to find. You might find some high-end sporting arms down here. You might find, oh, beautiful M1 Garands, trench shotguns, more trench shotguns. Gosh, M1 Garand snipers. Johnson rifles, the contenders, Johnson rifles. There's also a pair of the Johnson manufactured machine guns in the sale as well. You get to some foreign military here. You have some French RSC, and then back into some of the American sporting, and plenty of black guns as well. Plenty of modern things. You still need an FS 2000? You know, we have those. It's not just Colt and Winchesters here. It's not just gorgeous double barrel shotguns and Springfield trapdoors. It is the gamut. If you are a gun collector with 3,000 guns here in a sale, we will likely have something for you. As you can see in the cases, there's Colt snake guns, Colt wheel guns, Smith & Wessons, Rugers, rare ammunition in rare boxes. Well, you name it. And last but not least, some more German military and Krieghoff Lugers. Always a treat. Here's your prototype North American Arms 1911. If you know anything about M1911, you know that they are rarer. They're just about the rarest one, as that they never officially entered production. Those that were assembled were done in a borrowed plant with borrowed production pieces or materials, and then assembled from parts. And so any examples of a North American Arms 1911 are supremely collectible. And gold Civil War sword. If you haven't seen the video on that, you know what to do. Check out the other videos on our YouTube channel. Well, ladies and germs, thank you for spending some of your morning with me. We walked around for 20 minutes and I've been rambling on about all the guns in the auction, but it's easy to do when there are so many in one sale. As a reminder, this is preview day, Thursday, all day, today, from 10 to 6. We are open to the public, so please, please come visit us. Look at these things for yourself. And then afterwards, stick around. We always have a party after preview day. There's live music, a couple cold drinks, some chow, and a lot of like-minded firearms enthusiasts to talk to, just shoot the breeze, make some new friends. And you never know the next connection you're going to make at a Rock Island auction. So thanks for sticking around this morning. Hope you enjoyed it, and hope to see you at preview day. And if not, you can still check out the items on rockislandauction.com. Have a good morning, everybody.